Hi, freshmen and seniors too. I love you guys also.
Oh, we didn't forget sophomores and juniors too.
At first, when we first started, I was doing my work during regular school hours. So like I would wake up probably around 9 and I would do all my work. And that would usually take me to about 3 o'clock. So I was free for the rest of the day to do whatever I wanted.
Here is my advice to you guys. If you are like me and you binge all the time, it's better if you knock your work out as soon as you wake up. Like just get rid of it and then you're free to binge for the rest of the day and do whatever you want.
But as time went on or whatever, like I lost my sleeping schedule, so I started waking up a little later. And I found that like I couldn't really do all my work in that time frame, and I felt a little unmotivated sometimes. So I tried my hardest to do a couple of my assignments at a time. And because my assignments weren't due the next day, I was able to prioritize and do like the easiest assignments first and then do the harder ones later, and just keep it pushing like that. But I always at the end of the day made sure that I did a couple of assignments every day just so I wasn't bombarded the night before an assignment was due.
I think that this whole online course thing has really been helpful with like learning how to manage and prioritize work, because in college we're gonna have to do a lot of that. Some classes will be online and we'll be in our dorms. So it's helpful if we already know what to do. So this might not be all bad.
So something that I like to do is make sure that I'm sitting up straight when I'm working, so that way I feel productive and I give you guys the best that I can, because when you're laying and slouching, you're kind of relaxed. So I wanna make sure that I'm sitting upright and I'm focused on the task at hand. And also, I like to give myself periodic breaks, you know, work for 2 hours, take a break for an hour. So that way you can really relax your mind, because we're going through so much and we're processing so much, so you wanna give yourself time. And something that's unsuccessful is that I've been worrying about things that are outside of my control. So you really should try to focus on what you can control in your immediate life and look for the positive in everything that's going on. Even if there seems like there's nothing positive, just try to focus on one thing that brings you joy in that day.
I make a list of 3 things or 4 things that I want to accomplish the following day. So sometimes those are things like go for a walk. So if it's Monday night, maybe on Tuesday I decide I want to go for a walk tomorrow. I think that will be good for me. Or just go out in the sunshine. You know, it's good for your mental health to be in the sun. So I make that list of 3 to 4 things I want to do. Some of it might be taking a walk, maybe getting some exercise, doing yoga on YouTube, something like that. It might be cooking a certain meal that I know is like good for my body, healthy food. It might be like watching a movie. That will help me relax and just de-stress. So yeah, every night I make that little list and then I check the things off as I do them.
Talk a little bit about where we are in these moments and what I'm doing to stay sane. So I'm just hanging out on the roof. I'm up here, I don't come down, no. This was just a day out, a sunny day, and that's one of the things that makes me happy. I'm trying to think of all you guys in the prayers and in the hallway and saying hello. I miss that. I miss the connection with everybody and the stories that I hear from you and the other teachers. I hope that you're safe. I hope your families are safe.
Just want to let you know that we are thinking about you during these difficult times. I know this is an unideal situation for you to be bringing in your senior year this way, but we do want to encourage you to keep working hard. Make sure you submit all of your assignments on time and do the best you absolutely can. If you're struggling and you need help, there's so many people here willing and ready to support you. So reach out to your college guidance team, reach out to your teachers, reach out to admin or anyone in the CRB community, because we are incredibly proud of you. Keep working hard. We cannot wait to celebrate you. We miss you and we love you. Crush it, 2020.
I miss you guys so much. Los extraño muchísimo, and I can't wait to see you again.
Hopefully I get to see everyone again soon, because I miss all my friends and teachers.
And that I miss everybody so much. The thing I miss most about not being in school is 100% my students. I miss them so much. You guys just are the highlight of my day. You're the reason why I come to work every day and do what I do. The reason I became a teacher, the best thing about being a teacher is the connection I have with my students, seeing their smiles, hearing their jokes, getting their hugs. And so that's definitely what I'm missing most about being in the physical school setting.
I'll see you real soon.
Yeah, I'm out that Brooklyn. Now I'm down in Tribeca, right next to the Narrow. But I'll be hood forever. I'm the new Sinatra. And since I made it here, I can make it anywhere. Yeah, they love me.